Why does sunlight make you sneeze?
Cause sun teases our nose.
No.
Oh.
Wait, I'll explain. Hmm. Sneezing caused by sunlight or bright light is called photic sneezing. According to a prevailing theory, it happens because of a thick nerve bundle called the trigeminal nerve. The trigeminal nerve detects or senses irritants in our nose and thus triggers sneezing to expel them out. Huh? The trigeminal nerve lies quite close to the optic nerve, which sends visual information from our eyes to the brain. Now, in some people, this optic nerve is oversensitive.
Hmm. Just like me, right?
Oh, just listen. When bright light suddenly stimulates the optic nerve mistakenly transmits some signals to the nearby trigeminal nerve. Hence, the trigeminal nerve misinterprets this signal as an irritant in the nose and thus triggers sneezing.
Oh.
What is frostbite?
An ice candy.
No. Huh? Our core body temperature is about 37 degrees Celsius, or 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit.
Hmm.
To maintain this temperature, our blood transports warmth to all our body. But prolonged exposure to cold temperatures can decrease our core body temperature.
Oh no. Now what to do?
Now, our brain constricts the blood vessels of our limbs, diverting blood to the vital organs to maintain their core temperature. As our limbs don't get sufficient warmth, they start to freeze, giving us frostbite. Frostbite progresses in three stages. First is frostnip, in which the surface of our skin freezes. During the second stage, called superficial frostbite, often ice crystals form in the skin. During the third stage, that is, deep frostbite, the underlying tissues, blood vessels, bones, etc., freeze and may get permanently damaged. What is fracking?
A dance form!
Deep inside the earth, there is a layer of shale rocks. These rocks contain fossil fuels like oil and gas in their pores. To extract these fuels, a technique called fracking or hydraulic fracturing is used. In fracking, a vertical well is drilled into the layer of shale rocks. Then, the drill is turned by 90 degrees and drilling continues horizontally. When the targeted distance is reached, the fracking well is encased. Then, a perforating gun is inserted into the well. When the perforating gun reaches the required distance, the rocks are perforated. Then, the perforating gun is removed, and a fracking fluid is pumped into the well. This fluid builds pressure in the perforations, creating cracks in the rocks, thus releasing the fossil fuels. These fuels and the fracking fluid are then drawn to the surface. Why do we shiver when we feel cold?
Because our body is on vibrate mode.
Oh no. We shiver because our body tries to keep us warm. Our core body temperature is about 37 degrees Celsius or 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit. A part of our brain called hypothalamus controls and maintains the core body temperature.
Will it also maintain my physique?
Oh, please listen. Usually during cold months, the temperature is quite low. Hence, if we have not worn any warm clothes, we feel cold. Our body temperature starts to decrease. This decrease in temperature is instantly detected by our hypothalamus. Thus, it sends signals to our muscles to contract and relax rapidly, making us shiver. This rapid contraction and relaxation of our muscles generates heat. This heat warms our body, thus helping us maintain our core body temperature. What causes brain freeze?
An empty wallet.
Nah. Brain freeze or ice cream headache is a short-term headache. Scientifically, it is called sphenopalatine ganglioneuralgia.
Oh man, what a complicated name.
Indeed. In the back of our throat, there are two main arteries. They are internal carotid artery and anterior cerebral artery. They supply blood to the entire brain. Now, when we have cold foods, such as an ice cream or a cold beverage rapidly, the temperature in our throat drops suddenly. This causes the two arteries which are supplying blood to the brain to contract quickly. As there is a sudden change in the blood flow, it results in a type of headache called a brain freeze. It is the brain's way of telling us to slow down and have that ice cream or cold beverage slowly. Topic: human hair. Why do we get goosebumps?
To burst balloons!
Nope. Goosebumps served a purpose for our ancestors who had a lot of hair on their body. When our ancestors felt cold, their adrenal glands produced adrenaline. Adrenaline caused the erector pili muscles, which are attached to the hair follicles, to contract, creating shallow depressions on the skin surface and making the hair stand straight up, thus causing goosebumps. The straightened hair trapped more air, which prevented their body heat from escaping and hence kept them warm. Also, when our ancestors felt afraid of any animal, adrenaline made their hair stand up, making them look bigger and thus scared their attacker.
Yeah, dude, it scares me too.
Now, as this characteristic of goosebumps is inherited by us, we also get them during strong emotions or when it is cold. Why is the ocean blue?
Because ocean water reflects blue color of the sky.
You are right, but not completely. The main reason for oceans to be blue is the way water molecules absorb and scatter the colors of sunlight. Sunlight has 7 visible colors. They are red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet.
Yeah, I saw them in a rainbow.
Now, when sunlight falls on the ocean, it passes deep into the water. Here, red, orange, yellow, and green colors of sunlight are absorbed more strongly by water molecules, while blue, indigo, and violet colors are not absorbed much. Instead, they are scattered, making the ocean appear blue to us. However, as the blue shades penetrate deeper into the ocean, eventually they also get absorbed. Hence, at greater depths, the ocean is completely dark. What is vocal fry?
It may be similar to a French fry.
Not at all. Vocal fry is a creaky or raspy voice seldom used in speech.
I thought it is used by leech.
Oh, gross. Just throw that away and listen. When we speak, air from our lungs passes through the vocal folds, making them vibrate. These vibrations make the air in our mouth and nose to vibrate, thus producing sound or voice. Generally, human voice can be divided into 3 ranges or registers. They are falsetto, modal, and fry. Most people speak and sing in the modal range. But sometimes, when we speak in fry range, our vocal folds slam shut. However, longitudinally, they are not stretched tightly. Air from the lungs bubbles out through this loosely closed fold, thus creating that creaky voice called fry. What is a tsunami?
I don't know.
Tsunami is a series of giant waves. In Japanese, tsunami means harbor wave.
And in Chinese?
Just listen. A wave is created when energy passes through water. Moving air or wind provides energy to water, forming regular waves. While on the ocean floor, when a tectonic plate suddenly slides beneath the other, the resulting earthquake releases a tremendous amount of energy. This energy spreads outward from the point of earthquake, triggering waves that can form tsunami. Initially, these waves are small in size, but they travel at great speeds. However, when the waves approach the shore, the rising seabed obstructs the energy of waves. This slows down the speed of waves. but the energy flux must remain constant, leading to an increase in the height of waves, thus resulting in tsunami. How can we smell things?
Dude, I don't have a nose, so how will I know?
At the back of our nose, there's a tissue called olfactory epithelium. It is covered with mucus. This tissue has specialized neurons called olfactory receptor neurons. There are about 40 million olfactory receptor neurons. These neurons are chemoreceptors, that is, neurons which detect chemicals.
Wow, they have a cool name.
Now, when any substance releases its smell or odor, the odor consists of chemicals. When we breathe in, these chemicals enter our nose. When they reach the olfactory epithelium, the chemicals get stuck in the mucus, causing them to activate the neurons. As a result, these activated neurons send signals through the olfactory tract to the brain, informing it about the smell.